Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Policenauts Blind for the Sega Saturn. I am Amethyst Lunatari. Yes, Jonathan's ex-wife Lorraine asked him to look for her husband, Kenzo Hojo, before she was killed. Having obtained Ed's help, Jonathan visits Tokugawa Pharmaceuticals, Hojo's place of employment. It seems he was involved in the development of a DDS capsule called K9. Some suspicious writing on the whiteboard leads them to BCCH next, which is the Beyond Coast something hospital. Sure, we'll find out in a couple minutes. We're driving to BCCH, not to Hosier's house, because we don't know where it is. I'm just wanting to see if there's any new dialogue here.
Okay, Jonathan. Hojo-kei-mukazo.
Hojo-no-ie-ka.
どうした? Jonathan.
Are we doing know where his house is?
気が進まない。 触れてはいけないのかもしれない。
Jonathan. もう片足を突っ込んでるんだ。 引っ返せない。
Is it?
は。
避けては通れん。
分かってる。 北条家。 ロレインの家。
Is it saying we're not supposed to be going there yet? It's not stopping us. But I figure we won't be able to get very far, and we'll have to go to the hospital.
ここが北条家らしい。
ここにロレインが。
娘のカレンがいるはずだ。 彼女に話を聞こう。 ジョナサン、 娘のカレンはBBCの人気キャスターだ。
Oh, she's the one.
カレン北条。 聞いたことがあるだろ?
Yeah, she's the one in the news.
ロレインがそんなこと言ってたな。
The news article.
ニュースキャスター? もしや。
That's why she looks like Lorraine.
彼女はロレインの生き写しだ。
Mm-hmm.
ロレインの娘か。
Lorraine.
いいな、ジョナサン。 30年も経っているんだ。
Enough, Jonathan.
お前にとっては3年前のことに思えるかもしれんが、 冷静に受け止めるんだぞ。
Alright, let's do this. Let's talk to her first. First we'll look around at everything. These are some beautiful trees. It says, Jonathan, these trees belong to the Hojos themselves. Wow. No control plates? Right. These don't belong to the colony. They're privately owned. Must be nice having a piece of nature you can call your own, Ed says. The building's got a hint of Japanese architecture, Ed says. This is just stunning. You don't see many houses this big on Beyond, especially ones with non-standard architecture. What's that? All residential buildings on the colony have to follow certain architectural regulations. Even if you own the land, you can't just build anything you want. Sounds like fun. So is this place breaking the law? They'll get away with it because they're with Tokugawa. They make exceptions, then. It's a magnificent structure, well out of reach of people like us. Ed says, it has a real extravagant construction. Extravagant meaning wasteful. Wastefulness is the biggest luxury here. Could you really call this extravagant? This is like cramming a couch into a spaceship. Windows? Anything different from windows? We can't see inside for the adjustable glass, Jonathan says. Ed says, with the colony shaped like a cylinder, normally both neighbors are able to see inside your house. It's one of Beyond's biggest problems. Look at all the windows they have, Ed says. This place faces the central axis. It must have a nice view. You wouldn't normally have so many windows. The windows are made from adjustable glass. You can't see in at all. I'm guessing this could set up for all windows. These columns look that like they're cypress, it says. Normally we use reinforced lumber on Beyond. Some special kind of wood? Wood that doesn't burn or rot. It's to help prevent fires. Any fire on the colony could threaten the entire place. So is this non-standard too? Yeah, they aren't keeping with regulations. Everything about this place screams Tokugawa. They'll be among Beyond's elite. Jealousy can make people do crazy things. Lorraine was very well dressed, I remember, Jonathan says. She had an expensive bag and coat, too. Tokugawa employees must make even more than they say, Ed says. Jonathan says, after seeing this, I'm not sure we can rule out he was kidnapped. Well, Tokugawa employees do earn a lot, yeah, but no one would ever touch them. Beyonds know what happens when you screw with Tokugawa. They must be really well off if they can afford real wood, Ed says. They don't look nice. You don't see these very often around here. What's this up here? Oh, it's just the windows closed. Alright. So much as we're not going to talk about the steps, right? Yeah. It's the front door, Ed says. They've got a security camera, Jonathan remarks. Let's ring the doorbell. You ready? Ed asks. I'll ring the doorbell. How do we...
BCP のものです。ちょっとお話を伺いたいのですが。
BCP? ちょっと待ってください。セキュリティを解除しますから。ID をカメラに向けてください。
こうかな。
How do we know this address? He didn't tell us this address.
ロレイン? いや。
あ。
カレンさん?
ええ。カレン・ホージョーです。あなたは?ジョナサン・イングラム。あなた、イングラムね。
ああ。
そうだな。
Sounds excited.
帰って。どうして私たちの家族につきまとうの?
Oh boy.
これ以上私たちを苦しめないで。お願いよ。
カレンさん、そんな気はない。俺はただ、地球でロレインに、君の母親に頼まれたんだ。父親を探し出してほしいって。
あなたに会いに行ったばっかりに。どうして父や母が。どうしてなの
I don't know.
あなたよ、ジョナサン・イングラム。いつもあなたが原因よ。
It is?
あなたが。あなたが母を殺したも同然よ。
That's not true.
隙間とうのはやめてください。父は私が探します。帰ってください。
カレンさん。
She's a little upset.
あなたはジョナサンを誤解してる。
あなたは?
私は BCP の風紀課のエド・ブラウン。ジョナサン同様、君の母さんの古い友人だ。ジョナサンがロレインや君たちを苦しめるなんてとんでもない。俺はこいつと古い付き合いだ。こいつのロレインへの気持ちは誰よりも知っている。
知ってるわ。母さんもあなたのことをずっと思ってた。母は父にいくら言われてもあなたの写真いつも持ち歩いていたもの父さんかわいそうだった母さんは忘れなければならなかったのよそのことで父と母は喧嘩が絶えなかったわ私はそんな二人を見て育ったのよ幼い頃からジョナサン・イングラムを恨みながら
Damn.
知らなかったすまない。
カレンさん、君の気持ちはよくわかる。だが、ジョナサンを恨むのは間違っている。こいつはつい3年前まで宇宙をさまよっていたんだ。
カレンさん、聞いてくれ。君も君の父さんも大変な事件に巻き込まれてるかもしれない。俺は君たちを助けたい。君たちの力になりたい。
カレンさん。どうか分かってくれ。
分かったわ。うるさくされると迷惑だから。中に入って。
ありがたい。
Sounded very excited there, didn't he?
さて、どうしましょう、刑事さん。
外観もお金がかかってたが。へえ、内装も素晴らしい。
Okay, we can look around at everything, and there's quite a few things to look at. This is a nice view you have here, Jonathan says. You don't have any screens for your windows? There are hardly any insects on Beyond, so window screens aren't that important. The only bugs you find here are the ones like bees for pollinating flowers, it says, flies for decomposing waste, and earthworms for enriching soil. We never need to open a window either, really. Ed says, every house on Beyond comes complete with its own life support system. They're as self-contained as any spaceship. You never know when a leak in the colony could occur. I like opening the windows, though. There's something relaxing about it. You can see outside perfectly, Jonathan says. That's adjustable glass for you. Standing here looking outside, this place doesn't feel much different from home. It's weird. This plant... Are these plants real? Asks Ed. Yes, they're selectively bred to absorb large amounts of carbon dioxide. It's nice having the room full of fresh air all the time. Mom liked these. She really liked these. What do these speakers belong to? Ed asks. They go with our home entertainment system there. Is that a new... glass entry? I don't remember home entertainment system. Of course, doesn't mean I could have forgotten. Are these those new cordless speakers with biomaterials? Right, it's an infrared system with no dead areas whatsoever. They're ultra thin, and you can even hang photos or paintings over them, Ed says. Yes, but Dad has never been one to do that. They're all-purpose home entertainment speakers. We've got them in every room. Ed says the speakers are positioned high like that for the 3D sound, right? Yes, it's also to prevent vibrations in the inner walls. Is this new? No, this was here. I read this. Alright, what else we got? Looks like a stereo system or something here. Or something similar. Look at this, Ed says. Man, a high-fidelity, all-in-one home entertainment system employing 3D sound mapping and VR. With this system, composers are able to create a truly immersive sound experience that blows that old surround sound stuff out of the water. Karen says, it's made by Tokugawa Electronics. Dad was able to get it at a reduced price. He got a lot of perks to his job, huh? Ed says, this system revolutionized the home entertainment industry. You can set the sound map however you want, right? Yes, that's right. You mean the 3D equalizer. That's it. The 3D equalizer. The sound map automatically adjusts according to your location. It's got sensors that detect where you are, Karen says. Karen says, it also has an optional feature that increases alpha wave activity in your brain. It does this by mixing in high-frequency sounds with whatever media it's playing. Why would want to increase alpha wave activity? Oh. Karen says, these are the CD shelves. This is Dad's hobby. Listening to music is probably his favorite thing in the world, besides work. Ed says, I can see why with this setup. He must enjoy it a great deal. He's got almost every genre you can imagine here, Karen says. Ed says, CDs are an antique media nowadays. Right, but Dad doesn't like the quality you get online. Jonathan, finally speaking, says, this is some collection. Ed says, your dad seems like a real audiophile. These CDs will use 3D data codes, right? Yes, that's correct. Would you like to put something on? Don't tell me we can play anything out of this. That has a cat face on it. The title is Home. Jonathan says. Written and performed by La Nakamura. Play. Can we listen to this? Jonathan asks. Sure, go ahead. Are we really going to sit here and listen to it? This would be a good YouTube video to just play all these. Can we really play all these? Nobody Knows. The Nakamura. We know this song. Okay. I actually like this song. It's very 80s, like... Kind of reminds me of... Well, the bass definitely reminds me of, like, Seinfeld and the whole... I don't know. It sounds like something... I don't know. What Falcon Crest? I don't freaking know. So these are all individual songs. That's crazy. Snatcher, One Night in Neo Kobe City, unreleased remix. Written and performed by Motoyaki Furukawa, Kuheya Club. So we got Snatcher songs. Oh my god. I'm getting into it. It's a different version of the Snatcher theme. Well, it's a pretty cool. So for those of you who don't know, this is the opening theme for Snatcher. So if any video, I haven't gotten any content ID hits, copyright stuff on YouTube for any of this stuff. But if I got hit by anything for any of these videos, it would be this one, because there's all these different songs. I'm not sure if I should go playing all of them, a little snip of each one. 28 Years, written and performed by Ika-chan. It's definitely, you can hear the doot doot doot, it's definitely from this. I don't know, do we want to be giving away music? Girls, 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 really? Not the Motley Crue version. Yeah, I remember this. It's just definitely already, like, becoming classics as we speak in my head. Beyond Coast. This is the... Do, 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 do. Oh, now? Alright. Well, that would be Home. Shadows by Tappy. I think this is what was playing when we were in his office back in old LA, Home, aka Earth. I think. Dear friend. La Nakamura and Huggy. Huggy. Downstairs in Vice, maybe? BCP. Oh, this will be Vice then. Yeah, I remember this. This is when we were talking to Dave and... What's her name? The Amazon redhead lady. Good humor. Some of these songs I'm looking forward to actually hearing again. This is new. That was new to me. Still walking. La Nakamura. Definitely. Didn't we hear this at the beginning of this episode? Might have. We were driving here, I think, maybe? I don't really usually pay that much attention to the music. I'm focusing on, you know, talking to you guys and wondering what's going to happen next and whatever. Lavender Tappy. Owl Cat by Tappy. Ooh. Oh, there's the owl. Where's the cat? Maybe that was the cat. Ooh, like a very sneaky, sneaking around kind of thing, kind of song. Polynet Warriors, The Decade, by Kazuki Murakawa, with contributions by Dokuro Umeno. I like it. Oh God. It's so 80s. Very high energy though. I'd say 80s feel with the 90s high energy aspect to it. Tokugawa by La Nakamura. This is probably what was playing while I was reading all those glossary entries. Oh no. Oh, this is something else having to do with Tokugawa. Like very old style, you know, Asian music. Children of the Dream by Nakamura and Gaki. These names. Tappy, Gaki, Huggy. Sounds like a sweet romantic song. So she... I'm not really giving anything away because I don't know, but... What's her name? Karen? She's a Karen. Oh, brother. She's first and forefront on the cover. Look at my thumbnails for this series. She's in the middle. And it's Jonathan to the left, I believe. And then to the right, is it that guy guy with the... He's a Frozener that we talked to on the plane and then met in the AP room, but he was real nasty. And we really don't like each other. My Love. Aww, La Nakamura. Time for making some sweet love down by the fire. Enough of that. Still haven't finished the first shelf. Bike Ride on Nakamura. Sounds kind of thrilling. Doing Just Fine by Tappy. The Tappy songs are pretty, most of them are pretty jazzy sounding. Tokyo Mambo, also by Tappy. Ooh. That sounds interesting. Okay, next. Too Late Blues, Tappy. Not what I was expecting. The Blues Fling Girls. Nakamura. Is that one in the middle? Or is that part of the other one? Oh, it's the same. I went. All right, never mind. So that's the same one. I'm trying to back out. So that's one. Okay, never mind. So this is all one. Got it. Home Sweet Home, Ika-chan. Anna's Theme, Part 1. Nakamura. Who's Anna? Living in the Real World, Nakamura. Festival on Beyond, Tappy. We're gonna recognize this music as we go along, but I don't think it's really that much of a spoiler, because I'm not even playing. I'm only playing the first few, like, I don't know, what, 10, 15 seconds? This pink one. L'Amour Impossible, Tappy. Yeah! Isn't this when Lorraine comes to visit? Sounds familiar. Not Made in Texas, Tappy. Sounds like it was made in Texas. Mist, Tappy. Assuming this is the same thing. Yep. Past year at Sunset Beach. Tappy. Old LA 2040, short version, Tappy. Criminal Investigation, Part 1, La Nakamura. Yep. Very familiar. I don't think we need to hear more of that. No, 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 Tappy. Magic Subway, Tappy. Are we going on that subway thing? That'd be cool. Hey, might. Just because it's called that doesn't mean we're going on it. Hey, this one doesn't have a title. It says the cover's blank. Maybe it's part of something else? There's no title on this one anyway. Anywhere. Can we listen to this? Sure, go ahead.
Okashina. Ungak ga naranai.
Hen ne. Honto, noise bakari ne.
A clue of something? There's no music on it, Jonathan says. It's nothing but noise. Maybe it got damaged, Karen says. I think that's a clue of something. First triangle, Tappy. That sounds familiar too. Femme Fatale, Tappy. Sounds more like a sentimental fatale, or femme sentimental? Femtimental? Calling your name, Ika-chan. Theme Part 2, Nakamura. Now this one's been catching my eye the whole time. It's an interesting look to it. Polynet Warriors, Go For It, Yoichi. Kazuki Murakawa. With contributions from Cameo Motano. Sounds like a comedic and or high energy part of the game. I like it. Sounds like if you're in somewhere else, like in a VR or something like that. Mission 307, Tappy. Tappy's works. Guess who? Like atmospheric stuff? Just drum stuff? Nakamura Blues, guess who? Hope you guys aren't too bored. Hopefully I remembered to put an annotation that we're just playing this stuff. This is gonna be, I'm just gonna wrap up the episode doing this stuff. Legendary Faces by Tappy. Oh yeah, this we've heard. This is from the intro. A very cinematic sound to it. So I'm guessing this is the same, yeah. What's this? Love Theme by Motoaki Furukawa Kokeha Club. There's quite a few songs that sound like love songs or sentimental, like heartbreaking type songs, either one. Beyond Morning, Ika-chan. Sweet Hippo, Tappy, on the home stretch. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 more to go. That sounds funny. Arabesque, Tappy. Sounds like classical music. Memoir de la Neige. Memoir of something. Of the something. Tappy. Classical or neoclassical. Reunion. Motoyaki Furukawa Kukeha Club. If I'm saying that right. Mm-hmm. Oh, no. Same one. Finally. Chase. Motoaki Furukawa, same club. Well, that one disc must be a clue to something, that silver one. This one. Well, I don't have an option to take it, not saying anything else about it, so we'll just remember it's there. Sure, it's going to play a role. Kind of role in something. So I'm going to cut it off here, actually, a longer episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode when we do more than sit around and listen to CDs in someone's house instead of actually talking to them. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.